What's going on, everybody? Bill Cosby, this ain't him, this is just some random guy. Bill Cosby's appeal of sex crime conviction accepted by state Supreme Court. Wife hopes for vindication. Basically, the Pennsylvania Supreme Court said Tuesday that it had accepted convicted sex offender Bill Cosby's appeal of his 2018 conviction, thus raising the possibility it might be overturned in the future. The court limited its review to two key issues from Cosby's appeal, which were raised during his two trials on charges of drugging and raping a woman at his Pennsylvania home in January 2004. Under Pennsylvania law, the high court did not have to accept Cosby's nearly 300-page appeal in which he raised multiple issues objecting to the conduct of his two trials. Andrew Wyatt, a spokesman for Cosby, 82 and now serving a 3-to-10-year sentence in a state prison, said the former TV icon is extremely thankful. As we have all stated, the false conviction of Bill Cosby is so much bigger than him. It's about destruction of all black people and people of color in America. Wyatt said in a statement to USA Today, "We're extremely thankful to our attorney for their tenacious efforts in fighting for the vindication of Mr. Cosby. Cosby's appeal had already been turned down in full by an appeal court with all of his objections rejected." Cosby's wife of 56 years, Camille, told ABC News Live Tuesday that she was celebrating the possibility of vindication. "That is the goal," Cosby said. "Finally, there's a court, the state's highest court, that says, wait a minute, there are some problems here. This can be considered for an appeal." Cosby focused on the white accusers for their claims against her husband. "The Me Too movement and movements like them have intentionally ignorance pertaining to the history of particular white women who have accused black males of sexual assaults without any proof whatsoever." Cosby said they need to clean up their acts. "We know how women can lie," Cosby added, saying that the women making sexual assault charges against Cosby have not ever, none of them, presented any proof, and I think that says a lot. In the one-page order, the Supreme Court, the Supreme Court said it would review the appeal panel's decision on Cosby's case based first on whether the trial judge's decision to allow other accusers to testify about alleged uncharged prior bad acts by Cosby was prejudicial as opposed to probative, a standard used to allow or disallow testimony. The other issue the court will review is whether the trial judge improperly allowed testimony about a civil deposition Cosby gave after he said he was promised by an earlier district attorney that he would not be prosecuted. By relying on that promise, was Cosby induced to make self-incriminating statements later used against him? And does that violate his constitutional rights against self-incrimination? Under the usual timeline, the high court would next set a briefing schedule and eventually a date for oral arguments before the court. The Pennsylvania Supreme Court has narrowed the issues on appeal, limiting them to prior bad acts and the sovereign edict. Montgomery County District Attorney Kevin Steele said in response to the news, "We look forward to briefing and arguing these issues and remain confident in the trial court and Superior Court's previous decisions." Steele prosecuted Cosby at his two trials, both presided over by Judge Stephen O'Neill. The first trial in June 2017 ended in mistrial after the jury was unable to reach a verdict. The second was in April 18 when the jury voted to convict on three counts of aggravated sexual assault of Cosby's friend, former Temple University staffer Andrea Constan, at his home in the suburbs of Philadelphia. One of the only differences between the two trials was that in the first, O'Neill allowed only one prior bad acts accuser to testify. At the second, he allowed five accusers to testify. The high court said it would review whether such testimony was too old, whether the details of the accusations differed too much from the alleged at the trial, whether that was more prejudicial than probative, and whether allowing such testimony constituted nothing but improper propensity evidence. Jennifer Bongean, one of Cosby's appellate lawyers, said the granting of the Cosby appeal is extraordinary because it's so rare for state high courts to accept appeals. She said the court willingness to re-examine use of testimony about old and uncharged crimes against Cosby could affect other cases in Pennsylvania and elsewhere, especially Me Too cases such as the conviction of ex-Hollywood mogul Harvey Weinstein on sex crime charges in New York in February. Bongean said it's a foundational principle of American criminal law that just because a defendant might have done something in the past does not make it more likely he's done something now. It's a matter of law that you can't introduce propensity evidence, Bongean said. We've been swept up in a time when there's a lot of emotion and so much Me Too momentum that it was considered unheard of to question women. We should take women accusers seriously, but not accept everything hook, line, and sinker without any sort of vetting. So, Gloria Allred, a woman's rights attorney who represents dozens of Cosby accusers, including witnesses at the two trials, which she attended, said the Supreme Court will review whether there were errors in the second trial, and if so, whether those errors were harmless or could lead to a reversal. If the trial judge had allowed 19 witnesses to testify as prosecutors originally sought, Cosby would have had a stronger argument, but he didn't do that. He limited to five. All the rest said, is there a magic number here? The court will have to look at the trial record and see, but I think there is no magic number. Constant, who now lives in Canada and is an advocate for sexual assault victims, posted a lengthy tweet respectfully asking the court to consider the enormous prospect of putting any perpetrator back into the community after being labeled a convicted sexual violent predator. While even convicted criminals have the right to appeal, Constance said the true heroes are the women who testify as prior bad acts witnesses against Cosby, and their rights matter most, she said. If the court were to overturn Cosby's conviction, the prosecutors would have to decide whether to retry him again at a third trial. Depending on how it rules, the high court could also issue instructions that preclude prior bad acts witnesses from testifying at a third trial, Bongean said. For now, Cosby remains in prison and is not eligible for release due to the coronavirus pandemic, which has affected many state and federal prisons. His legal team is considering whether to seek his release on grounds of age and blindness, pending the high court's review of his appeal. Now, basically, sorry for all that, but what do you think? Do you think Cosby did it? Do you think he deserves to appeal? What do you feel? Me, I feel like she's lying, and I feel like Bill Cosby was at worst a cheater and a womanizer. I believe that higher ups are now bringing this back to give him a chance to appeal because of Harvey Weinstein and because of all the race and the riots going on. It's just another distraction. But Bill Cosby, I'm gonna have another video. This is about to end, but Bill Cosby was innocent to me. The worst he did was womanize. And if he was doing such these heinous acts, why bring it up years later? Everyone knows Cosby tried to buy NBC. They didn't like that. They warned him the first time. He tried it again. And this time they set an example to show him, you're not as powerful. You're black.